Enough. You are about to enter the domain of the Undertaker. Welcome to Hell's Playground. Welcome to Satan's structure. Welcome to Hell in a Cell.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are at the Great American Bash, and we kick it off with a tag team match. We started with Rene Dupree and Sylvain Grenier, also known as La Resistance, versus Special Powers, which consists of the Hurricane and Eugene. This is to determine who will be number one contender for the WWE Tag Team Championships, who are held by Rated RKO, that's right, Randy Orton, and Rated R Superstar, Edge. And the next title shot will be held on the next episode of SmackDown. So hope you go to enjoy this 1 hour plus show, pay-per-view right here. This will be awesome. Hope you don't want to enjoy from start to finish. And let's see the entrance of Sylvain Grenier. These two have been on the roster for a couple months, not doing much, but they are trying to get claw up to the ranks of being your future tag team champions of SmackDown. But we also have a new tag team of the Hurricane and Eugene, which was nominated from one of the comments that were left on our previous episode. So if you want to go back and check that out, be sure to also look at most of the comments that were left on almost every episode. Thanks to everybody who left their comments down and got picked for what is happening on the show. So we see the team of La Resistance in the ring.
Stand back! There's a hurricane coming through!
And here we go, we have one member of Special Powers, the Hurricane. The Hurricane was drafted over. He was a free agent a couple months ago, but he got drafted to SmackDown, and now he is teaming up with the unlikely duo, Eugene. They are also known as Special Powers. Speaking of Eugene, he is about to make his presence known very soon. Be sure to also witness our next matches that will be coming up in the final 30 minutes or so. So we will see the United States Championship being put on the line, defended in a parking lot brawl. Chris Jericho is your champion, going one-on-one with John Cena. This one is going to be interesting. This is John Cena's specialty. John Cena has chosen a parking lot brawl. So will John Cena pick up the victory, or will Chris Jericho beat him in his own stipulation? Chris Jericho has already done that in the previous SmackDown episodes. He defeated John Cena in his home state of West Newbury, Massachusetts. And let's get this match underway. We see a nice tag team tornado elimination style match. This one is going to be a little bit interesting. Who is going to get the upper hand in this match? As we see the Hurricane, oh, very nice Death Valley driver, or vertebrator actually, on to Rene Dupree in a low blow. But you have to do everything you can to try and become number one contender in this match. Now let's talk about our other two matches we see. We also have a 30-minute Iron Man match. It is Rey Mysterio versus the Cruiserweight Champion of SmackDown, Shawn Michaels. This one is going to be awesome. That is a not-to-miss match right there. They had a match at our Super SmackDown show a month back, and unfortunately, nobody picked up any victories, and the time went to a draw. So this one has to be a victory for both men. Who is going to win? Time will tell. But in our main event of the night, a massive main event, a Hell in a Cell match. We see The Undertaker versus JBL, and it is for the World Heavyweight Championship. JBL is the contender. The Undertaker is the champion. As we saw Eugene do the massive leg drop, and look at that nice German from Rene Dupree, the Frenchman. Now, Eugene is in control over there, doing the Junkyard Dog special. And he knocks Sylvain Grenier, and now Sylvain is in trouble. Rene Dupree is in trouble also from the Hurricane, but Sylvain changes his man and goes to the Hurricane. Hurricane has a abdominal stretch, but he lets go of that move, and now Rene Dupree lands a nice hip toss onto Eugene. Now we see a knee to the midsection from Sylvain. Sylvain, fight back! Rene Dupree is staring down a helpless Eugene, but Eugene gets back up. Eugene is back on his feet. And what's going to happen here? Eugene! Oh, takes down Rene Dupree. And now the Hurricane sidekicks Sylvain down to the ground. And now Junkyard Dog special onto Rene Dupree. Hurricane Dog for a massive pin here. 1-2, it is in a bridge, but it did not pitch up the victory for the Hurricane. The referee is in the middle of that move. But look at this, Eugene doing all these fancy moves now into a pinning combo. Going for the 1-2. Oh, Rene Dupree kicks out just in the nick of time. And now Sylvain going for a back body drop onto the Hurricane. Now Eugene trying to get his gatherings back up, but Sylvain and Rene Dupree caught him off guard. And Sylvain manages to go back to the Hurricane and pitch up some more damage, but it looks like the Hurricane is back to level ground and it is back in top notch. Elbow off the top rope there onto Sylvain Grenier. And now look at this, going to a headlock. Has the arm roll out. Oh, very nice takedown from the Hurricane. The Hurricane could be flying here. He could be flying. Elbow again. But look at this. Punches and punches onto Eugene. Wait a minute, another punch, almost a sucker punch onto Eugene. Now a submission is being applied over there. Onto the other side, but who's going to tap out? Is he going to get out? The Hurricane trying his best, but he could not pick up the submission victory on that one. Hurricane going high, he dropped down. Eugene now gets taken to the outside. Rene Dupree mocking him. The Hurricane better watch out. The Hurricane better watch out for Rene Dupree, but Rene Dupree is not taking any notice of anybody. He's taunting Eugene, and Eugene could be in trouble. What's happening here? Another vertebrae. Another vertebrae onto Sylvain Grenier from the Hurricane, and Eugene is back on the offense. But not for long, not for long. Ooh, Sylvain gets taken out. The Hurricane is going after Rene Dupree. Here we go, what's going to happen here? It's a 2-on-1, but it looks like Rene Dupree's coming back. Ooh, Rene Dupree going after Eugene after Sylvain was out. Here we go, a pinning combo there. Go for the 1. Oh, unfortunately, again, a kick out from Rene Dupree. What is going to happen? Irish whip into the corner from Sylvain to Hurricane. Hurricane is coming back now after Eugene just did a massive drop kick to Sylvain. Irish whip to the ropes, but Sylvain turns his way to the other person. And the referee's out. The referee is down. Anybody try to capitalize? Submission maneuvers on both men. The referee's out, so it does not count. Eugene breaking or attempting to break up. Sylvain's, there we go. Now what's going to happen? What's going to happen now? Wait a minute! Eye of the Hurricane! Eye of the Hurricane onto Sylvain! Sylvain got taken out, a fisherman suplex onto Eugene, but wait a minute! The Hurricane doesn't see it! The Hurricane did not see it! A fisherman suplex took out Eugene! Eugene has been eliminated, and it is now a 2-on-1! Low resistance has the upper hand, but will the underdog, will the Hurricane take care of business here after taking the eye of the Hurricane onto Sylvain Grenier? He had the chance, but the referee was distracted with the fisherman suplex pin onto Eugene. That is just too bad for Eugene and the Hurricane. That could have been an upset, but unfortunately, oh well, it looks like a handicap type match here. Eugene has to go to the back. And Hurricane has to deal with the problems. Can he be an underdog? Can he fight back with these two massive men? Oh, neck breaker. Flying neck breaker from... But wait a minute. The Hurricane trying to fight it back. Oh, my God. It dropped. It takes him back down. Oh. Look at this. They don't even want to take turns. They just want to try and beat him up. Wait a minute. A roll up. A roll up from the Hurricane. But Rene Dupree is right there to break it up. So it does not matter. Wait a minute. Punch. Punch. And now, look at this, another punch, a sucker punch. We've seen that done to Eugene in a couple minutes gone past, and it looks like, oh wait, a low blow, but no, Hurricane is stuck in the middle. One down, there's another one to pick up the scraps, and it looks like this one could be over very soon. Unfortunately, special powers do not look like they're going to come back from this. Massive backbreaker there. And Rene Dupree joins with a pin. It looks like the Hurricane could be out of it. And it is all over. The Hurricane and Eugene could not pick up the victory. Unfortunately for that team. But luckily. Luckily for Low Resistance. They are now number one contenders for the next episode of SmackDown. Now, as I was talking about before, as I was saying that comments were left and we took them into consideration and we also made them a positive to our shows. Now, speaking of comments, this is a feud that sparked a month ago after our last pay-per-view, which was Judgment Day, our first ever pay-per-view. This was a feud that started from a comment who suggested to put Carlito and Shelton Benjamin into a feud. And that's what we did. This is to end the feud. This is an ultimate submission match. This match will go for 10 minutes. And who will ever tap out will be victorious. But the match will not end. It will end at the end of the 10 minutes. So whoever wins during the 10 minutes will win the feud. Now also, from the last couple of weeks on SmackDown, this feud has been going up in the ratings. This feud has been two thumbs up. And unfortunately, in the last couple of weeks, it went down to a thumbs down. It was being taken advantage, must be too long, so the fans have changed their minds on this feud. But this is the final match to this feud. So will we see a great ending to where fans agree that it was a good feud from starting but unfortunately dragged on to the end, or will this match be a downer for most fans? Here we go, the match has started, and now we see Shelton Benjamin versus Carlito. Now surprisingly, Shelton Benjamin is actually a submission specialist. So will we see a submission move being applied here? Look at this, a massive reversal there. Carlito tried to go for a atomic drop, but Shelton Benjamin reversed it into a bulldog. Very nice, very nice, very well scouted. Look at his kicks from Shelton Benjamin. He had to watch out from his lethal kicks. He is also very athletic too, so you better not go onto the top rope or else he will climb up there and grab you down and put you onto the mat. But yes, this match is based on submissions. And look at that, I told you about those educated feet of Shelton Benjamin. Who will submit? And who will tap out in the first 5 or so minutes? Very nice belly-to-belly suplex there. Belly-to-belly overhead suplex. And now let's see what's going to happen. Shelton Benjamin going for the leg, maybe going for a submission there, but Carlito reversed it. Off the ropes, Carlito goes, but no. Shelton Benjamin stops him in his tracks and now goes behind. What's he going to do there? Abdominal stretch, the first submission of the match. The first submission of the match. Will he tap out? A very nice abdominal stretch. We've seen this in the previous match as well, but unfortunately nobody has tapped out yet, but it is too early to tell. So we will see how worn down their bodies will be once the 10 minutes are up. As I stated before, be sure to check out our three main events That includes John Cena versus Chris Jericho in a parking lot brawl. That also includes the Iron Man match, not just an Iron Man match, a 30-minute Iron Man match between Rey Mysterio and Shawn Michaels for the Cruiserweight Championship. Going for a pin, unfortunately, it's not a pinning type match, so Shelton Benjamin is a little bit, I don't know, but he's a little bit. And make sure to also check out our massive main event, Hell in a Cell, The Undertaker versus John Bradshaw Layfield for the World Heavyweight Championship. The Undertaker is your current champion. Shawn Michaels is your current Cruiserweight champion. And Chris Jericho is the current United States champion. And look at this, we see a surfboard type move being applied that will hurt your back and also your arms. Will this make Shelton Benjamin tap out? No, unfortunately, as I stated 5 minutes ago, we are still in the beginnings of the match, so it cannot affect them as of yet. But once you punch the bodies, once you get them worn out, and look at this, very nice. Oh, Carlito just landed on his feet. Now going for a scoop slam. Oh, very nice. Working on the arms and the lower back of Shelton. Perhaps going for a submission move. No, working on the lower back even more. Ducks under. Shelton Benjamin had something planned, but no. Needs to be in section. Shelton Benjamin hits Carlito in the back of the head. Now Carlito ties it up. And what's happening here? DDT. A plant DDT into the mat. But he also needs to land a submission move. We have to try and build up these submission moves. Submissions make the difference in the match. Punches there from Shelton. Punches. Does not take Carlito down. But look at this. Carlito now. Go for it again. Go for a Tommy drop again. There we go. It landed. It landed. And it also took some wear and tear off the legs of Shelton Benjamin. And that's what you have to do. As I stated before, during the beginnings of the match, those educated feet, you need to take them out. Carlito determines to try and do that. Now Carlito getting taken out. Very nice drop toe hold there, made famous by Ric Flair. Will Shelton Benjamin capitalize? Will he do a leg submission on that? Unfortunately, Carlito gets back up. And now Carlito now. Very nice tie up, but no. Chops there, chops again. And a nice takedown. Shelton Benjamin dragging Carlito. He's trying to go for the legs, but Carlito's too fast. He gets back up very easily. Now Shelton grabbing the head, grabbing the throw of Carlito. No, he's got a submission locked in. Very nice, very nice. Who's going to get this? Will he tap out? Will he tap out? No, unfortunately, but he lands a snap mirror, which does add that extra pressure to his neck. So what's going to happen now, Carlito? Irish whip into the bottom left corner. What's he doing? No, he does not follow it up. Perhaps a little bit too dazed from that submission maneuver, but what's going to happen? Irish whip now to the bottom right corner. But he's trying to also, it almost feels like he's trying to get Shelton away. Trying to say, you know, I'm already hurt, so please go over there while I gather my thoughts. Benjamin now back up to level ground and gets taken out with a massive punch from Carlito. We've seen those punches before. If you have not seen Judgment Day, Carlito took on perhaps the face of SmackDown. Perhaps one of the best of SmackDown, John Cena, in a United States Championship bout. And unfortunately, Carlito did not pick up the victory, but he can now say that he has gone up against John Cena and he has taken him to that point to where John Cena could have lost. And we also saw Shelton Benjamin last month in Judgment Day. He went up against Christian in a ladder match. Not on the pay-per-view, but on a SmackDown episode. I'll go for a sleeper hold. This could be it. The neck of Carlito was worked on before. This could be it, but no, unfortunately, Shelton Benjamin could not lock it in tight enough for him to submit. Now look at this, a sunset flip, perhaps trying to go for a pin, but unfortunately, like I stated 10 minutes ago, it does not count. It is only a submission type bout. Block there, another block. Back and forth, here we go, what's going to happen? On his shoulders, very nice, Samoan drop. Working the back, the torso of Carlito. Now Carlito back up. Carlito gets kicked to the midsection. Now a knee to the midsection. What's going to happen? Irish Whip fake out. Punch there. Alito punches in the back of the head. Trying to go for another one, but no. Now go for another move, but reversal from Shelton Benjamin. Elbows him off him. And now what's going to happen? Shelton going again. Going again for that submission to the head, to the neck. Will he tap out? Will the pressure get to Carlito? No. Oh, does not. But again, he uses that snap mirror to add extra pressure to where Carlito cannot tap out. Hip toss there from Shelton Benjamin. Carlito is dazed. Shelton Benjamin looks like he's locked. He's ready. He's ready to do some more damage. Carlito fake out. Punch there. What's he going to do? No. Reversal by Shelton. Shelton Benjamin takes down Carlito. Carlito is on the mat. Shelton Benjamin picks him back up. Now go for a T-bone. T-bone on to Carlito. But Carlito is in a pinning combo. There is no pinfalls in a submission match. These men do not realize it. I don't know if it's just the wear and tear on their bodies to where they think it's a pinfall type match, or I don't know, it might be just plain stupidity from both men. We are coming down to the final minutes of the match. There has not been any submissions to make their opponent tap out. So what is going to happen? Will we see it in the final 1 minute? We need to hurry this up. But look, the internals of Carlito are hurting. His ribs, his chest area. Carlito is in massive pain, but Shelton Benjamin needs to capitalize, and that is not the way to capitalize. It is not the way to capitalize. Look at this. Carlito cannot compete, but he still chooses to hang on. But Shelton Benjamin cannot capitalize on what he has to do. Now what's this, another Samoa drop? Yes, it is. Carlito is on the mat, on his back. Shelton Benjamin needs to do something. It looked like he was trying to go for a submission there, but Carlito gets back up. Carlito, wait a minute. Dragon whip there. Will that get submission victory for Shelton? Maybe not. Punch, reversal. Carlito. Now look at this. Back body drop. There we go. Back body drop. But can Carlito lock in a submission? We're coming to the ending minutes of the match. The time is standing still for these two superstars. Punch there, reversal there. Now another back body drop. Another back body drop. These two are wearing each other's bodies down. This cannot be good. Into the midsection there, punch there. Benjamin, another T-bone! Another T-bone onto Carlito, but oh my god, that does not pitch up the victory. Wait a minute, going after the leg, but he's stomping on it. He needs to lock and apply a submission. Look like he's going for a figure four leg lock, but Carlito just takes him out. Carlito reversed it, and now look at this. Carlito can't even stand up. And the time runs out. Before we get started, I'd like to give a special shout out to an independent designer who does YouTube designs, illustrations, and much more. Be sure to check out his channel and videos, all in the description box below, and an annotation is on your screen. This guy is the real deal. He gives you high quality images and much more than you even expected. So make sure to subscribe. He is awesome. Now, much like independent wrestling, be sure to subscribe to those independent designers who do not have a name for themselves as of yet. But when you go to their channels and subscribe and enjoy every video they upload, they will become bigger, and it is no thanks to you. So be sure to check out all independent artists, logo designers, illustrators, and animators.
The following contest is a hardcore match. On the way to the ring, accompanied by Ric Flair. From Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing 235 pounds, Christian.
We are now underway. This is our final undercard match. This is Christian, accompanied by the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, to go up against Randy Orton, accompanied by the Rated R Superstar, Edge. Now, Christian and Randy Orton have been feuding for the last week or so. Christian defeated Randy Orton on a SmackDown episode And that capped Christian's career off right there. That could potentially put him into a main event caliber situation.
And the opponent, accompanied by Edge, from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 245 pounds, Randy Orton.
Now Randy Orton, after suffering a loss to Christian, has been trying to fight his way back. And these two have a tough task ahead of them on SmackDown, where they go up against your number one contenders, La Resistance. Now those two have met before, but this time it will be interesting. After La Resistance defeated the team of Eugene and the Hurricane, also known as Special Powers, this is going to be a massive match to look forward to on SmackDown. And now tonight, we look ahead to what Randy Orton will do to Christian. Ric Flair is right there to back up Christian. Ric Flair was our traded superstar from Raw. We traded him with Tori Wilson. But unfortunately for Raw, they could not capitalize on Tori Wilson's contract. So we took her right back. And now the match has started. Christian up against Randy Orton. A massive DDT to start it off. Wow. Christian showing some strength, and look at this, slapping Randy Orton. I don't know if that's a good thing to, or a bad thing to do to a veteran like Randy Orton in this type of match, but also Christian is perhaps the veteran, actually. So, who knows? Low blow again! Christian now showing his strength, and look at this, he's trying to go for a figure four leg lock to show to Ric Flair, but Ric Flair not getting that. Now we know Ric Flair and Randy Orton have seen eye to eye before. They were both members of the team Evolution. But we have not seen those two go up against each other. So that will be interesting if they do in this match. So, and we also know that Christian and Edge are also teammates in the past. So what will we see? This is interesting. Now that you think of it, what will happen? Will Edge go up against Christian, or will Ric Flair go up against Randy Orton? Both men, both know each other's game plan and what will happen, so we'll see what happens. Christian versus Orton. So far, so good. Christian is in control. Now Christian going to the outside, picking up a steel chair. By the way, this is a hardcore match. Anything goes. Steel chairs, sledgehammers, announce tables, anything. What will we see? Sidewalk slam onto the chair! A sidewalk slam onto the chair! And now going for a kick to the midsection. Trying to go for a figure four leg lock, but Christian reverses. Now gets Randy Orton into an arm type lock there. What's going to happen? Now locks in a hammer lock onto Randy Orton, wearing down the arm. Perhaps trying to wear it down for a potential RKO out of nowhere. Now look at this. Randy Orton grabs the chair. Christian tried to hightail it out of there. Now going under the ring. What's got? He has a bell. He has a ring bell under the ring. Very interesting. Randy Orton trying to go for a steel chair shot, but Christian trying to go for a bell shot. Bell shot lands, but it does not affect it. Randy Orton. Why? Who knows? Another bell shot. Ooh, this time he's stunned. He's stunned, but look at that knee to the midsection, and now grabs the chair off Randy Orton. But Orton is very smart. Goes to the other side, and he has a chair. And you know what you get when you have two chairs, and look at that. Massive headshot there to Christian. Wait a minute, Ric Flair, what's he doing? Ooh, I thought he was going after Randy Orton. Yes, he does. And Edge goes into the ring, but for some reason, he just gets back out, and goes back in. But the referee telling him off. The referee looks like he's telling Edge off, don't go back into the ring. Okay, Edge is doing a little bit of crazy stuff in the ring. Ultimate opportunist, I guess. Now look at this. Randy Orton getting choked out from Christian. Christian has the offense. Now what's going to happen? Oh, Orton does not tap out, but very close. Now Orton and Christian has a chair, but Christian manages to wail it onto Randy Orton before Orton had the chance to. Now Christian goes back out. Ric Flair trying to do something there. Chops there. What the hell was that? A shot to Ric Flair. Oh, and a kick to the midsection from Randy Orton to add extra damage. A shot to Ric Flair. Christian just landed. And look at this. A sledgehammer shot to Edge. Both men attacking their own partners instead of the opposition of them. Now what's gonna happen? Pushing Joe to the outside, turning to Edge, but Orton stopped him. Orton just stopped him there. But it looks like Christian is getting damaged over there. Orton and Edge now teaming up, but look at this. Christian grabs another chair. Now Orton and Edge. I mean, Orton and Christian both into the ring. But not for long. Christian Joe's back out to Edge. Christian Joe's back out to the Edge. He's teasing him. He's teasing Randy Orton. He's like, I'm really going for Edge, but I want you to come out here. Oh, now look at this. This is what you call Ultimate Opportunist 101. That's what it is right there. Ric Flair just going in and out of the ring. Now look at this. Wait a minute. Christian gets back up. Ric Flair going in and out of the ring for some reason. Stop him. Referee needs to take him out. Look at this, he's ruining our match. Ric Flair is ruining our match. What is this? Get out of the ring. Get out of the arena, Ric Flair. Look at Randy Orton, he's like going in just to try and defend the camera. But look at this, now Christian taking it out to Edge, but Edge runs away from that. And look at this, a massive shot missed there. Another headshot missed. Oh, what a shot. What a massive chair shot to Christian. Christian could be out of it. Ric Flair trying to do something here. Irish whip to Edge. Christian has been put into a chokehold there. Christian, both teams are not doing nothing. Christian could be out. Christian taps out.
Randy Orton.
So what you did not get from our last match, you did it in this one. Randy Orton managed to tap out Christian onto the outside in a Taz Mission type sleeper hold there. Very nice from the team of Rated RKO, which goes into SmackDown. Now, coming up, we see a massive United States Championship match. It is John Cena versus United States Champion Chris Jericho in a parking lot brawl. This has the favor of John Cena. John Cena's stipulation of choice is the parking lot brawl. And will this favor John Cena, or will Chris Jericho take it above him and defeat John Cena, not only in his own hometown of West Newbury, Massachusetts, but in his own match stipulation? Let's see how it goes. Chris Jericho versus John Cena. And the match is underway. Chris Jericho versus John Cena. Both men have been going at each other for the last month now. Month or two. Right after Judgment Day, it was a triple threat match. Edge, Chris Jericho, John Cena, in John Cena's hometown of West Newbury, Massachusetts. Hold that thought. Chris Jericho going for a dirty pin right there. Count of a one, two. Oh, so close. Not to mention, that is on a concrete ground. So yes, as I was saying before, it was Chris Jericho, Edge, and John Cena in a triple threat match in John Cena's hometown of West Newbury, Massachusetts. And now look at this, T-Bone. And Chris Jericho managed to capitalize, take the pin, and beat John Cena in his hometown. Unbelievable. Edge was so close to winning, but Chris Jericho managed to sneak in there, pick up the victory, and then brag on and on and on about how he defeated John Cena in his home state of Boston. Look at these quick pins from Chris Jericho. Once again, one. Only a one count. Now, if you did not see our SmackDown Super Show, which went over an hour, Chris Jericho versus John Cena was at that match in a tables match. Those two, oh my God, onto the back of his head on a concrete ground. Now, those two had a massive bout on the SmackDown Super Show in a tables match. But in the ending minutes of the match, we saw an attitude adjustment, or an FU, through the announce table, but then Chris Jericho got back up, managed to hit John Cena with not one, but two steel stairs, and Chris Jericho took advantage and put a scoop slam into the table, so John Cena could not get up. And the winner of that match, a new United States champion, was Chris Jericho. Now, for weeks now, Chris Jericho has been holding that United States Championship, walking around like he is the man of SmackDown, defeating John Cena and your United States title. Wait a minute, oh my God! Onto the bonnet of the car, or maybe it's the hood of the car, but cracking the window and now going for a submission. Very nice strategy from John Cena. Wow, Chris Jericho had to be hurting after that. After hitting the windshield or the back of the car. I'm not sure if that's the back of the car or the front of the car, but either way, damaging. But look at that, not as much as a low blow. A low blow right to John Cena. But anything goes in this match. It's a parking lot brawl. What do you expect? And now look at this, into a sleeper hold. Oh, cracking the neck of John Cena. John Cena is hurt. But he gets back up. He gets back up. And now what's Cena going to do? Oh, trying to go for something, but Chris Jericho goes into a roll up. Now goes for the one. Only a one count. The referee's a little bit slow on that reaction, but Chris Jericho is trying his best. Chris Jericho is trying to, I don't know, he's trying to get every type of pinfall in this match. Perhaps trying to steal a victory or trying to get out of this match without any cuts, bruises, or scrapes. Now a submission there. Onto the leg. We know that John Cena has bad knees. Will this work? Will this work? But no, unfortunately, John Cena gets out of it. But for what cost has that have to John Cena's leg? What cost does it have to John Cena in the future of this match? Punches exchanged. Now Chris Jericho with a knee to the midsection has John Cena into a small package. Go for the one, the two. Oh, this goal. Oh, what a near fall right there. Wow, you could have counted that to 100. Oh, that was close, very close. Wait a minute, Chris Jericho going for the walls. Chris Jericho going for the walls. Walls to Jericho, walls to Jericho. Walls of Jericho applied there, but John Cena, will he tap out? Will he tap out? Will he tap out? No! Now Chris Jericho back on the offense now, but unfortunately John Cena has his number. Irish whip reversal punch there. Chris Jericho now reverses, kick to the back, and now, oh, trying to go for a massive, lariat, but unfortunately, John Cena hits him with a massive clothesline, takes him down to the ground. Now Jericho back up, chops there, reverse though, John Cena tie up, hip toss onto the concrete, right next to the limo. That looks like JBL's limo. Now going for a submission there. Going for another submission, applying another one. This got to wear out Chris Jericho's body, back, and also his mind. So what's Cena going to do now? What's Cena planning now? Drop kick, very nice. John Cena has one of the best drop kicks on SmackDown. Now going for a tie up, and look at this, jawbreaker, but look at the knees of Jericho. That could have hurt it more than what John Cena got there, but Jericho going for a leg submission. Could this be it? No, not as of yet. Cena kicks out of that. What's Chris Jericho have now? John Cena goes behind, but Jericho punches him. Now John Cena gets hit by a punch. Tie up there for Jericho. Reversal by John Cena. Chops there, very nice. Oh, back to the chops from Jericho. Irish whip into the car bonnet. Into the car bonnet. And now look at the car smoking. The car is steaming and the bonnet is up. Wow. You can't see me punch. Misses. Drop kick misses. Oh, flying lariat misses as well. John Cena. Oh, into the limo. his head first into the windshield of the window, well, you know, the window of the limo. But nobody gets hurt after that because the window did not crack, but his head bounced off that right into a backbreaker from John Cena. That backbreaker took out the Hurricane. Could have taken out Chris Jericho, but Chris Jericho managed to stay right in there. Drop kick from John Cena. John Cena looks like he's doing good right now. Now Bulldog there. Bulldog from Chris Jericho. Now going for another cocky pin, but no, that does not pick up any type of count. Now John Cena going for a move, but no, look at this. Ties it up. Very nice hip toss there, or an arm drag actually. Goes behind. Drop kick, but no, misses. Reversal by Jericho. Irish whip. Fake out. Oh, Luther's press from John Cena. Raining down with punches. And John Cena looks like he's on an attitude adjustment type thing now here. Wait a minute. Speaking of attitude adjustments. F you onto Chris Jericho. But it looks like John Cena's worn out. John Cena's worn out. Will he capitalize? Will he get there in time? Yes, he does. Will that land him a three count? One, two, three. It's a three count. John Cena is your new United States champion.
Here's your winner and the new United States champion, John Cena.
John Cena in his own stipulation, in his own match type, managed to pick up the win.
The following contest is an Iron Man match. And introducing the challenger from San Diego, California, weighing 165 pounds, Rey Mysterio.
And now we go to our co-main event of the night. It is your 30-minute Iron Man match between Rey Mysterio and your Cruiserweight champion, HBK, Shawn Michaels. This one should be epic.
And it's for the Cruiserweight Championship of the World. From San Antonio, Texas, weighing in at 225 pounds, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
At our first ever WWE Judgment Day pay-per-view, we saw Rey Mysterio defeat his opponent to become number one contender for that Cruiserweight title, and now is the chance to get it on. Now, Rey Mysterio attempts to shine in the spotlight against Shawn Michaels. Now, it is Rey Mysterio's time to shine and see who is the true Cruiserweight of SmackDown. It is the most controversial type match that was built up from last Super Show on SmackDown, where it was Shawn Michaels and Rey Mysterio in a 10-minute Iron Man match, or shall I say 15-minute Iron Man match, but it did not go either way. Both men were tied up and it was a draw, but now we set that one up to 30 minutes, and now who will win? There must be a winner in a 30-minute match. So here we go. Shawn Michaels trying to go for the legs after Rey Mysterio's little miss at the start. But look at this running bulldog onto Shawn Michaels. Very nice. You will not see any ground and pound type moves as of in this match, because this match is bound to be airbound, because we're going to take our first class trip to flying cruiserweight challenges and action right here. Nice punch to Shawn Michaels, and now look at this, grabs the legs, but not, oh my god, a leg drop onto the head of HBK Shawn Michaels. If you have watched the entire show from start to now, I want you to leave a comment, and let's see what that comment will be. Let's say, you know what, leave a comment and put down 619, just because of Rey Mysterio's chances of what could happen tonight. So leave a comment down in the comments below, and leave 619. But let's see who will pitch up the momentum in this match. As Shawn Michaels goes, reverses Rey Mysterio and knocks him down with ease. But look at this. Oh, nice leg lariat onto Shawn Michaels. Shawn Michaels is down. Rey Mysterio trying to go for a running start, but nothing happened. Now look at this. Shawn Michaels kick in. Oh, very nice reversals by both men. Now look at this reversal from Rey Mysterio. Grabs the arm. What's he about to do? Oh, very nice takedown. And now taking that arm in hostage, but it's a rope break, and he's forced to let go. Now look at this. Speaking of high fly moves, look at this. Oh my god. Twisting corkscrew off the top onto Shawn Michaels. And another one, but this time a standing one, but it looked like Shawn Michaels reversed it. And now what's going to happen? Shawn Michaels goes behind Rey Mysterio. Oh, you know what happens when he's on the second rope. Rey Mysterio is about to dial it up. Leave it in the comments. 619. And now he's about to get it ready. He's about to get it started. West Coast pop. There we go. Goes for the pin. Referee has the one. This could be it. Two. Three. Oh, not even a three, but he heard the thump right there. It's not a three count, but you heard it. Wow, that is a 2.5. And this will go until the time runs out. So any man to pick up how many victories they want until the end of time. So let's see how it goes. Rey Mysterio already landed the 619. Now a drop kick to the back. Remember, Shawn Michaels has lower back problems from when he fought The Undertaker back in the late 90s. But now look at this, choking out Rey Mysterio, perhaps using the mask to his advantage. Now Shawn Michaels trying to give some punches to Rey Mysterio, but Rey Mysterio firing back. Now has control of the arm, takes that, and punch to the back of Shawn Michaels' head. Punch again, and now look at this. Oh my god! Oh, very nice! Into a pin, but no, Shawn Michaels did not want any of that. And now what's going to happen now? Rey Mysterio with a knee to the midsection. Irish whip, fake out. What's happening? Runs to the top left corner. Another corkscrew. Jumping dive onto Shawn Michaels. Shawn Michaels is on the mat. Rey Mysterio jumps over him like a piece of trash. Now look at this. Trying to go for the leg, but he gets taken off. Rey Mysterio gets reversed by Shawn Michaels. And now look at this. Elbows to Rey Mysterio. Kick to the back. Shawn Michaels gets taken into the second rope again. Again, now look at this, running a start. This could be it. 619, oh my god, 619. Now we know what's going to happen next. The West Coast pop. There we go. Could this be the first victory of the night? One, two, oh, and again, Shawn Michaels stays in it. Again, Shawn Michaels stays in this match. And look at this, and planted him right there in the middle of the mat with a DDT. Now has a key lock applied and works on the arm. Very nice, very nice. And now look at this. Shawn Michaels going to the leg. What's he about to do? Work on the leg. Very, very good strategy from Shawn Michaels. The veteran in him, the veteran instinct in Shawn Michaels will get there. So let's see now. What's he going to do? Knee to the midsection. Irish whip. Fake out. What's he about to do? Punch. Reversal. Another reversal. Shawn Michaels has the back. But Rey Mysterio would not let it up. Now it's a tie up. And now look at this. Very nice ground game from Rey Mysterio. Takes down Shawn Michaels. Punch there from Rey, but reversal. Now Shawn ties it up. And a very nice gut wrench slam. Referee checking Rey Mysterio to see if he's doing good. So far, so good. This match is still at a tie. 24 minutes in. This match is still going strong. No victories as of yet. What will happen? Reversal of Shawn Michaels. A kick. Again, reversal of Shawn Michaels. A kick. Reversal of Rey Mysterio. Kick to the midsection. Another knee to the midsection of Shawn Michaels. Drags the arm down. Wow. Very nice. Very good strategy from Rey. Very good strategy from Shawn. These two know each other. After the last Iron Man match they had. But that was only 15 minutes. This is 30 minutes. Add 15 more onto that, and you've got yourself a main event caliber type match here. And now look at this. Working the arm again. Both men working each other's arms. And now Shawn Michaels. What's he about to do? Stalking Rey. Punch there. Knee to the midsection. Irish whip. Fake out. Knee again. Another fake out. Now a tie up. Ooh, reversal by Ray. Ray gets trying to do something, but no. Elbows to Ray, and now Shawn Michaels goes behind, and now look at this elbow to Shawn, and now look at this. Ray Mysterio, go high flying. Oh, again. Corkscrew. Feet to the face of Shawn Michaels. Shawn Michaels could be out of it from that move. Now what's Ray about to do? Go for the legs. Has his legs up and jumps over again with a leg drop. Nice modified leg drop right there. Only Rey Mysterio can do that in the business of professional wrestling. And now look at this. Rey Mysterio reverses what Shawn Michaels had planned. Running start. A drop kick from Shawn onto Rey. Rey Mysterio is staggering. Rey Mysterio is in trouble, but he goes back to the top rope. Oh, but Shawn Michaels catches him with a diving attack there. But wait a minute. Shawn Michaels again. This is the third time. Third time. 6-1-9. And now, to cap it all off, he's going for the West Coast Pop. Will this be it? Three times is a charm. Will this be a 1, 2, 3? Oh, not even a 3 count. Not even a 3 count. It is always a 2.5. These men are fighting. Fighting for the Cruiserweight Championship. This is a massive co-main event. We've already seen 3 6-1-9s in the match. Unbelievable. Now Shawn Michaels in the bottom right corner. And Rey Mysterio with the monkey flip onto Shawn Michaels. Shawn Michaels is in the center of the ring. What will Rey Mysterio do to capitalize? Wait for Shawn Michaels and a heel over to Shawn Michaels. But Shawn Michaels catches Rey Mysterio while he tries to jump off. And a low blow. Not known for Rey Mysterio to do that, but in this game, anything can happen. Knee to the midsection of Shawn Michaels. What's Rey Mysterio about to do? Strong Irish whip onto the outside. Rey Mysterio takes Shawn Michaels to the outside. What is about to be happening from the outside? That is where the danger happens. And now fake out Irish whip. Knee to the midsection from Rey Mysterio to Shawn Michaels. But Rey Mysterio gets reversed by Shawn. Now Shawn Michaels gets back in and says, I don't want any part of the outside. Remember, our main event is still to come right after this match, as we've seen massive punches and another punch there from Shawn to Ray. In our main event, in our massive main event, we see a world heavyweight title match. It is The Undertaker versus John Bradshaw Layfield in a Hell in a Cell. That will be epic, but this match is still yet to become a phenomenon, because look at this. We are almost 20 minutes in, and this match has still not yet picked up a victory for either superstar. So what's this? Shawn Michaels now taking a page out of Rey Mysterio's book, but look at that. Rey Mysterio took a page out of Shawn Michaels' book and lands another corkscrew diving moonsault there, and goes again. Another corkscrew off the top rope. Shawn Michaels is getting damaged with all those corkscrews from Rey Mysterio. We told you this will not be a ground and pound type game right here. This will be a high flying, all impact type match here. And speaking of impact, we see Rey Mysterio put Shawn Michaels not once, not twice, but 4 times for the 6-1-9. And now going for his 4th West Coast Pop. This could be it. Counter ref, 1, 2, 3. That is the first victory for Rey Mysterio. Rey Mysterio is in the lead now. Shawn Michaels is in the danger zone, as he will potentially lose that title if he does not pick up another victory. This could be damaging for Shawn Michaels. Speaking of damaging, his head looks to be hurting right there. This could be it for Shawn Michaels. He needs to pick up a victory to put him back into the lead or tie him up to Rey Mysterio. But look at this. Shawn Michaels cannot even stand. He can't even stand. Oh. He got to feel the pain that Shawn Michaels is going through at this time. Shawn Michaels now gets strong Irish whipped onto the outside. But wait a minute. Rey Mysterio. Oh my god. That's what we're calling one of the highest flyers in SmackDown Cruiserweight Division. And look at that. Going for the pin outside. Unfortunately, that's not how it works, but Rey Mysterio just proved how high he could go with that diving moonsault right off the second rope onto the outside of Shawn Michaels. They both go back inside, and look at this! Shawn Michaels attempted to go for a kick, and this is the fifth try for the 619. And that left Shawn Michaels busted open. That left him busted and bloodied open right there. Now here we go, West Coast pop again. One, two, three, two wins for Rey Mysterio. Two pinfall victories for Rey Mysterio. What does Shawn Michaels have to say to that? What does Shawn Michaels have to do to counteract that? Shawn Michaels is in desperate need. He needs to pull out a couple big switching musics to try and come back for this match. Fake out there. Massive jumping kick there, but it does not pick up the victory. Come on, Shawn Michaels, we need some kind of momentum from your side. We need a momentum push from your area. Jumping into Yuri there from Rey Mysterio. Shawn Michaels is busted and bloodied. You see all the blood all over this ring. And once again, 619s. This time on the other side. The Great American Bash, and it goes black. That is the emulator's problem. And we eventually see that's how devastating it gets. 619, West Coast pop. 1, 2, 3. Unbelievable. Three pinfall victories. Wow. We've just been over 13 minutes. Three pinfall victories. Shawn Michaels has not got even one. This is very, very dangerous for Shawn Michaels. He needs to pull out at least two victories in the next 10 minutes or so, because if not, I don't know what's going to happen. Shawn Michaels, there we go, nice clothesline. Very nice clothesline, but he cannot capitalize. He can't even grab him. He can't even see him. Shawn Michaels, oh, into an arm drag, but he's too close to the ropes. That will be called a rope break. There we go. Nice officiating from the referee. Now drags Shawn Michaels into the center. No. Very nice chop there. Punches. And a punch that took Rey Mysterio to the ground. What is Shawn going to do? Try to do something, but he gets reversed. Wait a minute, what's this? Kick to the midsection. Try to go for another kick, but no. Rey Mysterio reverses. Shawn Michaels goes behind. Uh-oh. Rey. Ooh, kick miss there. Michaels. Goes over and under. And look at this. He goes for a sunset flip, but it's too close to the ropes. If the ropes were not there, that would potentially put him up with a victory. But too close to the ropes, that's what you get. And now what's going to happen here? Rey Mysterio, Shawn Michaels stare each other down. And Rey Mysterio takes him out with a nice jumping clothesline. And a standing moonsault to cap it all off. What is going to happen now? Rey Mysterio going for a move. They're headlocked, but no. They both stand up. Very nice. Oh my god, very nice athletic skills from Rey Mysterio, and a low blow from Shawn Michaels. That's what you gotta do to these high flyers at times. When desperate needs, you need to do that type of strategy to try and capitalize and be the offense of the match. Rey Mysterio now. Snap me out, jumps over. Oh my goodness. Oh. Shawn Michaels is flat like a pancake, but he gets back up. That's just a showstopper mindset in his brain right now. So let's see what's going to happen. Uh-oh, here we go. And trying to go for a kick, but Rey Mysterio catches him with a kick. And there we go. Oh, not again. This will be number 7. 619. Number 7. Unbelievable. Oh, West Coast pop. Counter ref. 1, 2, 3. Rey Mysterio. By far the victor. The victor. No, the victorious person in this match. He's by far surpassed Shawn Michaels. It has not even become 15 minutes yet. You can already tell. It is just under 15 minutes now, so. Let's see how Shawn Michaels does, but I'm not too confident. Face plants, Rey Mysterio with the DDT. Look, you can't even stand up. You can't even stand up. Oh, a leg lariat. Tried to take him out, but that clothesline did. And now what's Rey Mysterio about to do? What is Rey Mysterio about to attempt now? Goes by, he's just playing with him now. He's just toying with him. Blocks that dropkick. All the blood is all over the mat. I'm just shocked that the referee hasn't done anything about this. Punch to the back of Rey Mysterio's head. Now they tie it up. Rey Mysterio reverses, goes behind and does a nice neck breaker. Rey Mysterio, four wins. Shawn Michaels, none. After that neck breaker, Rey Mysterio was confident he's going to pick up another victory. And he does with the neck breaker. He picks up another victory and it's 5-0. Now look at this, Rey Mysterio going all over around. Oh my god, takes Shawn Michaels out with the head scissors. And it looks like Rey Mysterio could pick up another victory with ease. With ease. But Shawn Michaels is still fighting back. That showstopper mindset, as I said before. Not taking Shawn Michaels out of action. He does not want to give up. What is going to happen now? Shawn Michaels trying to go for a move, but still Rey Mysterio reversing. Now, Rey Mysterio, no, Shawn Michaels now, DDT, we've seen him do that move countless of times, but he still has not picked up a victory with it. Unfortunately, he cannot stand up, as I was saying, he cannot stand up, brought him down to one knee. And now Rey Mysterio trying to go for another high flying move, but it looked like he felt sorry for him. But Shawn Michaels, not doing so well. But look at that nice clothesline. Oh, he's still fighting back. Shawn Michaels is still fighting back. He's not giving up. Low blow may take him down, but it won't take him out. Now look at this, shoving Rey Mysterio off. Punch to the head. Going for a neck breaker. Oh, but Rey Mysterio with ease just reverses. Now what's happening? Rey trying to go for a move, but look. Oh, Shawn Michaels. Insecurity, doesn't matter. Shawn Michaels gets taken out with an insecurity. Now, Rey Mysterio, what's he about to do? Oh, punch the back of the head of Shawn, but. Oh, Shawn is back up. Punch. Punch again. We are looking at a wonderful match right here. This is what you call phenomenal because. Oh, my God! The famouser landed onto Rey Mysterio. Rey Mysterio is busting wide open. Wow. We never thought that Shawn Michaels pulled that out of him, but somehow he did it. Now look at this. Knee to the midsection of Shawn, Rey Mysterio. Irish whip faked out. Oh, punching. Punching the bloody face of Rey Mysterio again. Wow, no remorse. Now if Shawn Michaels can just grab a victory out of nowhere, that would be awesome. You just take Rey Mysterio out of it. Wait a minute. Oh my goodness. Wow, we saw Rey Mysterio 10 minutes ago do a jumping dive from the outside, from the inside to the outside. And now Shawn Michaels trying to prove him wrong. Now what's happening here? Shawn Michaels reverses whatever Rey had planned there. And now going back to punches. Will we see something here from Shawn Michaels? He is building up the momentum. He is building up the momentum to try and get a victory from Shawn Michaels. But it looks like punches are coming down. And Rey Mysterio is just getting back up. Now he's dragging Rey Mysterio into the center. Oh no! Sharpshooter! The sharpshooter is being applied! The sharpshooter is being applied onto Rey Mysterio. Will Rey Mysterio tap out? Very good strategy from Shawn Michaels, but he did not tap out. Rey Mysterio just gets out of it, gets back up, and now attempted to drop kick. Oh, there we go. Drop kicks Shawn Michaels onto the outside. Unbelievable. Wait a minute, he's going airborne again. He's going airborne, buddy. Connected. And he also crashed and burned in the process. Shawn Michaels is down. Shawn Michaels is potentially out. And now submission is being applied. Oh my goodness, look at that submission. Look at that submission. Just wrenching the back of Shawn Michaels. Oh, unbelievable. Rey Mysterio is in the control of the match. In the driver's seat. Unbelievable. Once again, this has got to be number 8. Once again, 6-1-9 onto Shawn Michaels. And then going for the devastating West Coast pop. When you know it goes black, that means it's going to be devastating. And here it is, the West Coast pop. Referee to count up to 100. 1, 2, 3. That puts Rey Mysterio up to 6 wins. But look at that. Shawn Michaels not straying away, not giving up. He is still hanging in there. Now he's not hanging on the ropes now, but look at this. Shawn Michaels switching music. Oh, but Rey Mysterio blocked it. Rey Mysterio blocked it. He reversed. Rey Mysterio dodged out and reversed the switching music. Now Rey Mysterio going airborne, but he just stops. He stops and does an enziguri. Wow. Unbelievable. Shawn Michaels going for the switching music, but Rey Mysterio gets out of it. Reverses and just dodges out of it. And now what's going to happen? Shawn Michaels, does he have any other plans up his sleeve? Does he have any other momentum shifters? And what's this? Oh, double underhook. Double underhook slam. He needs to get a pin. A devastating move like that needs a pin at the end of it, but it looks like no pin will be coming anytime soon. Unfortunately for Shawn Michaels, he is in the danger zone, and I don't think he should come back after 6 losses. I do not think he will come back with a victory. Close to 10 minutes. It is close to 10 minutes, and I don't know if I can see Shawn Michaels getting a victory in that time. As we saw nice arm drags there, and looks like Rey Mysterio is back up to momentum. And trying to go for a kick, but Shawn Michaels hits him and punches him to the outside. Will Shawn Michaels try and gain momentum? But he gets taken out with a leg lariat. And now what's going to happen? Another enziguri. Another enziguri. Rey Mysterio trying to capitalize on Shawn Michaels. What's this? Another one. Another one. Is this number 9? Is this 6-1-9? And now again, going for the West Coast pop. Will this give him the 7th victory? West Coast pop. Referee counts 1, 2, 3. 7 pinfall victories in a row for Rey Mysterio. Unbelievable. Unbelievable match. This is what you call a phenomenal match, because Rey Mysterio, out of nowhere, he got number 1 contendership last month in Judgment Day. Defeated his opponent to become number 1 contender for the Cruiserweight title. And it looks like Shawn Michaels is a broken down man at this point. Shawn Michaels on the ropes now. Shawn Michaels Irish whips Rey. Rey ducks under, jumps off the ropes. Oh my goodness. Sit out. DDT. What was that? What was that? Rey Mysterio now, what's going on? Rey Mysterio trying to do a move, but it looks like Shawn Michaels is still trying to come back, but it is pretty much impossible at this point. Pretty much impossible. 7 victories for Rey, 0 for Shawn. I don't know. I don't see it. I do not see it at this point. Shawn Michaels has the arm. Puts it in a hammer lock. Ragdolling Rey Mysterio around for a little bit. Will he capitalize? No, he does not. Falls down. But once again, ducks under. Reverse DDT. Sit out style. Now it looked like he was trying to go for a 54 leg lock, but Shawn reversed it. Now dropkick to Shawn Michaels. Now don't count out Shawn Michaels. Last month. Oh, wait a minute. Oh my God. Switching music. You can call that a switching music if you want. But it was a super kick. But he cannot go for the pin. He cannot go for the pin. Unfortunately, cannot go for the pin, which could have got him a victory. But a shame. Now, as I was saying, don't count out Shawn Michaels. Last month, he went up against Randy Orton. That's right. One of the main events of SmackDown. He went up against Randy Orton in a ladder match. And he picked up the victory. Now Rey Mysterio jumped with the pin. One, two. Ooh, Shawn Michaels has the fight now, but will that stand in another 10 minutes? Will that continue on for another 10 minutes? Seven victories above Shawn Michaels zero, so not sure. But as I was saying, Shawn Michaels went up against Randy Orton in a ladder match. That match was the co-main event of Judgment Day. And that match did wonders for Shawn Michaels' career and Randy Orton's career. Now this one looks like it might build up Rey Mysterio's career after defeating one of the legends, one of the cruiserweights, the top cruiserweight in Shawn Michaels. Shawn Michaels fighting back though. He's not giving up. That's why you gotta give that to Shawn Michaels. He's not giving up. We are now three or so minutes, and look at that, he just takes it to the outside. Now what's happening here? Both men fighting on the outside. Maybe Shawn Michaels needs to get a count out victory. Punches to Rey Mysterio. Maybe he might get a count out victory. Look at this. Shawn Michaels on the inside. He's dancing like he's not done anything. He's dancing like he's not lost anything. But he still needs to build up that momentum. But no, Rey Mysterio gets back in. I don't know what's going to happen here. It looks like it's all game over for Shawn Michaels. It is all downhill from now. Hip toss right there into the middle of the ring. Shawn Michaels staring at the body of Rey Mysterio, but also trying to gain back his momentum. And now has an arm submission on to Rey Mysterio. Rey Mysterio, could he tap out? He cannot tap out. But wait a minute. Wait a minute. Shawn Michaels tuning up the band. Tuning up the band. He's tuning up the band. And you know what happens when it goes dark? That means it's even more devastating than ever, because it's a sweet chin music. And look at that, sweet chin music. It is more devastating than ever. Going for the pin. One, two, three. Rey Mysterio suffers his first loss in this Iron Man match. And Shawn Michaels finally gets back up to what he could do. Unfortunately, it is too little too late. And will that pay Rey Mysterio any mind of what could happen? Now look at this, going for a submission, choking out Rey Mysterio. Will this give him a tap out victory as well? It does, it gives him a tap out victory as well. Now Shawn Michaels is up to two. In less than 1 minute, can Shawn Michaels get up to at least seven victories? Can he get up to six victories in that time, or will Rey Mysterio try and wear and tear him down to where he can't walk anymore? Now look at this, Shawn Michaels reversing. Reverse DDT! Reverse DDT! Will he jump for the pin after that? He's dragging him in. It looks like he might jump for the pin. He's dragging Rey Mysterio into the middle. And no, wait a minute. He gets him up to a seated position. Oh, what is he doing? What is he doing? Shawn Michaels desperately needs to go for a pin, but no, he gets taken out with an incendiary. And unfortunately, this could be it, but wait a minute. Oh my god, reverse backbreaker there. A backbreaker onto Rey Mysterio. And another incendiary. It looks like Rey Mysterio is just playing around with him with tons of incendiaries. We are now down to the last 40 seconds of the match. What will happen? Will Rey Mysterio suffer five more losses? Or will Shawn Michaels suffer a devastating loss? DDT! DDT for Shawn Michaels onto Rey Mysterio. Rey Mysterio, remember, is busted open. And also remember, Shawn Michaels has been bleeding from the start, from almost the 10 or 12 minute mark. And now Shawn Michaels takes Rey Mysterio off the ropes. But it looks like it's all game over, as we are now down. Wait a minute. We're down to the last 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3. And now look at this. Rey Mysterio, such a flip powerbomb from the top rope. And there we go. The last man standing is Rey Mysterio. Shawn Michaels loses the match.
Here's your winner and the new Cruiserweight Champion of the World, Rey Mysterio.
Shawn Michaels suffers a devastating loss, losing his Cruiserweight title that he has held since the start of General Manager mode. But tonight, Rey Mysterio grabs the title in convincing fashion and is now the Cruiserweight Champion of SmackDown. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for the main event, and this is a Hell in a Cell for the World Heavyweight Championship. The Undertaker is your champion, and he is going up against JBL. These two have been feuding since day one. These two have gone after the United States title, world title, and now tonight, The Undertaker holds the title. And who will win the end of the feud? Alright, now the match has started. JBL, Undertaker, Hell in a Cell for the World Heavyweight Championship. This one is for all the marbles. This one is for all the gold. This one is to settle the feud and finish it for once and all. Elbow onto the Undertaker. Another elbow onto the Undertaker. And no, another elbow onto the Undertaker. Showing off right there. JBL just showing off. Wait a minute, a low blow there. A low blow from the Undertaker. But remember, anything goes. Will we see anybody escape the Hell in a Cell? Now, wait a minute. JBL going for a... Ooh! Backbreaker. I was going to say sidewalk slam, but it was a backbreaker. Punching Undertaker into the top left corner. Now stomping on him, leaving some mud holes. And now, wait a minute. More elbows onto the Undertaker. These two have been feuding, as I said before, since day one. Now look at this. Going for a single leg. Submission there onto the Undertaker. The Undertaker could tap out, actually. The Undertaker could tap out, but no. Not yet. This match has just started. Now what an uppercut from the Undertaker onto JBL. JBL is on the mat, but he reverses whatever Undertaker had planned there. Trying to go for another uppercut, but JBL reverses. Now comes back with a big boot to the Undertaker. The Undertaker is down, but not for long. Oh, here we go. What's going to happen now? Fake out there. Clothesline there. Short arm clothesline from JBL. Now raining down punches onto the Undertaker. If you remember from Judgment Day, these two went one on one in JBL's stipulation, a backstage brawl. Wait a minute, powerbomb gets turned into a DDT from the Undertaker. And these two went in all and out in a backstage brawl. A bar brawl, to be exact. But JBL could not pick up the victory. It was his stipulation match, but he could not pick up the victory. And now, these two have settled in a Hell in a Cell match to determine the end of the feud, the world champion, and perhaps the best. Low blow there from JBL. A boot gets reversed from the Undertaker. Punches from Undertaker to JBL, and now JBL in trouble. JBL gets back though. Go for another powerbomb. That didn't work the first time, and it doesn't work the second time as Undertaker plants him with a DDT onto the mat. But JBL always finds his way back up to vertical base as he hits a low blow. But the Undertaker not getting up, not leaving JBL alone. Irish Whip off the ropes. JBL in trouble, ducks the punch, and punches the Undertaker himself. Now Undertaker about to choke him out, but JBL gets reversed, and reversed by the Undertaker. Now these two have had title matches after title matches. Ooh, wait a minute. Right, JBL was on the ropes, staggering on the ropes, but not anymore. JBL is back up, knee to the midsection. Irish Whip, fake out. Now what's Undertaker got? Undertaker's still in trouble, but he reversed, kicked to the midsection, and another one, and he gets reversed from JBL. Now these two have had titles after titles, as I said before. JBL defeated the Undertaker for the world title. JBL defeated the Undertaker for the United States title at one point. The Undertaker had the United States title for a cup of tea, actually, but then the Undertaker got defeated by John Bradshaw Layfield, and then, in a surprising return from the Undertaker, distracted JBL, which cost him the match and which gave the United States title over to John Cena. Then John Cena lost that title to Chris Jericho, and now tonight, as you saw, John Cena could regain the title and is back up to where he belongs. And now tonight, JBL wants to regain his World Heavyweight title. We've seen two titles being changed tonight. Two titles. That did not happen last month. That did not happen in Judgment Day. Referee telling off JBL for those fists onto the Undertaker's forehead. This pay-per-view by far has already been a memorable one. United States title has been changed. We've crowned a number one contender for the WWE Tag Team titles for SmackDown next week. We've also crowned a new Cruiserweight title in very convincing fashion. And will we crown another title defense? Will we crown another title change in this match, or will we crown another champion? Undertaker has a nice submission applied there, but JBL, as I know, is very strong. But look at this, the Undertaker is worn out. The Undertaker is worn out. The Undertaker needs to fight back in this match. JBL has not done too much to affect the Undertaker, but look at this. Undertaker is worn out. Undertaker is, for some reason, staggering. Not good, not good at all. Irish whip off the ropes. Punch there from JBL onto the Undertaker. Undertaker now getting rained down with elbows. Another one. There we go, another elbow. And another one. Another elbow. As I said before, the showstopper, JBL. Undertaker, low blow and an uppercut onto JBL. JBL could be devastated after that, could be rocked. But wait, JBL back up. Oh, Undertaker knocks him down with a punch, but not for long. Tie up. What's this? DDT planted onto the Undertaker. Now the Undertaker in trouble. JBL stalking him. Undertaker saw it coming and he punches JBL to the mat. JBL in trouble now. Undertaker has the leg. Working on the leg. Very good strategy. You don't want JBL to run. You don't want him to do any moves while standing. And he is a tall man. He's like a 6'6" man. And you don't want JBL to stand for a long time or else he might hit you with a clothesline or even a powerbomb. As we saw before, he tried to attempt a couple power bombs onto the Undertaker, but the Undertaker managed to reverse. Trying to go for a diving clothesline, but he gets trapped into a couple elbows. And then another one. There we go. Undertaker, man. Wait a minute! Playing possum! Undertaker roll up! Undertaker rolls him up! Referee, one! Two! Oh, three, but the JBL kicked out, but I heard the three count. I heard the three count. Unfortunately, the referee was not there anytime sooner. He would have capitalized. But look at this. JBL takes the Undertaker down after missing. Whoa, wait a minute. Undertaker just sits up like nothing happened. Undertaker's ready. Undertaker's fighting back. Undertaker is ready to get JBL and knock him out. But look at this. Look at this. The pain. The pain of Undertaker. Literally cannot stand up. He cannot stand up. Could this be it for the Undertaker? Is this the beginning of the end? We've noticed in matches before, once they have low momentum, they don't survive for the last 10 minutes. What's happening here? Reverse from Undertaker. Undertaker into the midsection of JBL, but JBL reverses. And now what's JBL got? Sidewalk slam, it looks like maybe. No, reversal. Side rush your leg sweep. Or shall I say, side rushing. I did say that. Now what's happening here? Scoop slam. Oh my god, onto JBL. JBL could be out after that, but Undertaker is down to a knee. He cannot capitalize. We need Undertaker to capitalize to try and land a tombstone, a choke slam. Last ride. Undertaker has many moves. But look at this! Look at this, JBL! Going after the leg again! He started early with the leg, and now trying to finish it off with the leg. Very good strategy. The Undertaker's had many leg injuries. But it looks like Undertaker's withstood that, and now going after the neck. Going after the neck of the Undertaker. Undertaker should be out. Could be out of this. He could tap out. He could tap out, but no. JBL, still in it. Undertaker still in it with a running DDT. Undertaker now trying to build up that momentum. JBL is down but back up. Irish whip to the top left corner. Undertaker now, what's he about to do? What's he about to do? Tie it up. And reversal from JBL. JBL, what's a good plan? Clothesline, short arm clothesline onto the ropes, but Undertaker gets out. Oh, another short arm clothesline that takes Undertaker down, but not for long. They're back to vertical base. What's happening here? Grabs the arm and wrenches it down to the mat. Very great. Very good. Very momentum shifted from the Undertaker. Now Undertaker trying to go for a move right here, maybe. Oh, but no, reversal from JBL. JBL is on his A game tonight. JBL is on his A game. Feature four leg lock trying to be applied by Undertaker. Very surprising, but no. Now Undertaker catches JBL's leg. Oh, massive punch there from Undertaker to JBL's head. But Undertaker not staying down. And JBL not staying down. So what's going to happen? This match could go either way. Especially after those elbows. Both men losing momentum, losing stamina, losing every inch of their body health in this match. But both men are willing to go all or nothing. JBL going to the top. We'll never see him go to the top. My God. Oh, massive clothesline. You can call that a clothesline from hell. Now working on the leg. Great strategy there. You don't want him to go high flying. You don't want him to do running moves. You don't want JBL to do any type of move like that. But wait a minute, wait a minute. Oh, no. You know what happens when he gives that signal. You know what happens when he gives that signal. And it all goes black. But you can still sort of see it. It is the JBL powerbomb. There we go. JBL bomb. But JBL cannot stand up. JBL is not back to his feet. He needs to get back. But no, Undertaker gets back up. Undertaker gets back up. But JBL looks frustrated. JBL is frustrated and chokes Undertaker back to the ground. Oh no. Undertaker reverses whatever JBL had planned. Uppercuts his back. Not a good strategy. Oh no. JBL almost had it. JBL almost had the victory in his grasp. Wait a minute. Again, doing high flying moves. Again. Diving elbow. A diving elbow onto the Undertaker. But the Undertaker just sits up. He just sits up like nothing happened. Oh, no. Oh, no. No. He signals again. Oh, no. No. JBL powerbomb. Twice. Oh, but his momentum is stuffed up again. He's stuffed up his momentum. Will it grab the pin? Undertaker just sat up. Undertaker just sat up. Undertaker just sat up like nothing happened. And he just big boots JBL to the mat. Undertaker just sat up like nothing happened after a JBL powerbomb. Oh, he just shoves his head right into the mat there. What? Oh, this could be interesting. This could be interesting. What will happen? Undertaker just got taken out by two JBL powerbombs. And he sits up like nothing happens. He just sits up like nothing happened. Now looks like he's going back outside. It looks like he's going outside. We're going to have some Hell in a Cell action right here. Here we go. Oh, what a shot there from the Undertaker. And now goes back inside. Now goes back outside. And now goes back inside. But JBL going to the top rope. Diving elbow again. What is with Undertaker getting taken out with these diving elbows? Undertaker now stumbling. JBL on the hunt. On the prowl. What's happening here? JBL reverse. Gets reversed. Oh no, what's Undertaker doing? Powerbomb? Oh no, he hurts his head. Hurts his head. Very nice strategy there from the Undertaker. Teasing that he was going for the powerbomb. Very good strategy. Wait a minute! Wait a minute! No! No! Three times! JBL powerbomb! Straight into the pin! One! Two! We have a new World Heavyweight Champion, and it is JBL! John Bradshaw Layfield is your new World Heavyweight Champion of SmackDown. This is game-changing. Three JBL powerbombs onto The Undertaker, and it capped it all off with a world champion in the making. And your world champion for the future. Unbelievable. JBL new champion. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the show has ended, but let's get to the websites as we see JBL in the middle, and it looks like Undertaker has a little injury. Undertaker could be suffering an injury right here, so... But yes, the show has ended. What a great show. Oh my god. It was fun. It was so fun. I hope you all enjoyed it. Remember, if you watched it from start to finish, leave a comment down below saying 619. As we saw, 9 619s in that match. But yes, Great American Bash has been doing good in the ratings. And on your right, we see Batista's contract. Blah, 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 blah. But I believe that's it for this video. Make sure to leave a like down below and a comment to let me know what you thought about the entire video. But until next time, thanks for watching. The name is Dawn Day Evolution. The solution to the gaming community, which is littered with pollution. The most electrifying man in all of entertainment. No, I'm not quoting The Rock, I'm just making a statement. I am educated, dedicated, never duplicated. If you stand in my way, you're about to be a meme. See, a life lesson is just to be on top. I live by my motto and just defeat all odds.